Hi, and welcome to Spice and Pans. Today we'll be cooking seafood soup rice or 海鲜泡饭. So let's start cooking. Now we'll prepare the ingredients for the broth. In a pan filled with water, turn on the flame. Medium heat will be good. We are going to blanch 500 grams of chicken feet. You don't have to wait for the water to come to a boil because we want the blood and the scum to come out from the chicken feet easily. So now we'll just wait for the water to come to a boil. Now that this is boiling, we'll just cook this for another 5 minutes and then we will wash and rinse them and set them aside. It's been 5 minutes. Let's turn off the heat and we'll wash and set them aside. Now we'll dry fry our anchovies. I have with me over here 40 grams of anchovies or ikan bilis. Just rinse them up a little bit. Heat up a pan without adding any oil. We just put the anchovies in. Now you might ask, why is this step necessary? Because after dry frying this and turning this slightly brown, the flavor will be intensified. So this is actually a pretty crucial step in making a very good broth. I'm using medium to medium low heat over here. We don't want to burn this, we just want to slightly brown them and dry them up a little. When the anchovies are slightly dried up, we'll add in 1 tablespoon of white peppercorn. Keep moving them around, we don't want to burn them. There's no need to smash the peppercorn. We just want a little bit of a peppery taste to the stock or broth and not make it too spicy. Okay, now that the anchovies are browned, we'll just turn off the heat, put them in a muslin bag and set them aside. Now we'll shallow fry our dried sole fish. Heat up a pan. Add in some oil. Swirl the oil around. Using medium heat, add in 2 pieces of dried sole fish, approximately 30 grams. Put it in. We just want to brown this a little. The purpose of pan frying the dried sole fish is to enhance the flavor, like what we did with the anchovies. The flavor of the sole fish will be infused in the oil, so do not throw them away. We will use the oil to pan fry our prawn heads later. Slowly pan fry them, do not burn them up. Task fire setting is pretty crucial. Don't turn the heat up way too high, otherwise you'll burn this. Once the sole fish are brown, we'll remove them from heat and set them aside. In the same pan using the same oil, using medium heat, we'll fry 400 grams of prawn heads. Just in case you're wondering how come I have so many prawn heads, is that sometimes when I cook prawns without using the shell, I'll just remove the heads and keep them. They make an excellent ingredient for making very nice seafood broth. Don't turn them around too soon. We'll just pan fry one side first for a minute or so, and then we'll turn it to the other side. We need to fry this until they're fragrant so that your broth will be really flavorful and not fishy at all. Now we'll just flip the prawn heads over. And now we'll further fry them until they are really cooked through. If you do not have enough prawn heads, you can also use the prawn shell. Of course, heads are more flavorful. So we'll fry until the shell are cooked through. How do we know whether it's cooked through or not? It will be totally red. The prawns are now cooked. All right, just stir them up a little bit. Look at how beautiful the color is. We'll now add in 1 cup of water. Turn the heat up to medium high. Using a spatula, just crush them up a little bit so as to bring out the flavors from the prawn heads. Be very careful while we do this. If you are using a non-stick pan, do not use any metal spatula. A wooden one would be best to use because we don't want to scratch our wok. Okay, now that this is done, we'll just set them aside. We'll now prepare the broth. In a pot, fill it up with 1.5 liters of water. Turn on the heat to medium. Put in the anchovies and the peppercorn that we have assembled inside this muslin bag. Add in also the blanched chicken feet. Put in our sole fish. Add in 1 whole bulb of garlic, washed. 1 thumb size of young ginger, slightly crushed. And also pour in our prawn heads. Add Add in 3 grams of rock sugar. Don't have to put a lot because the prawn heads are actually pretty sweet already. Stir them up a little bit. We'll put the lid on and wait for this to come to a boil. Once the broth has come to a boil, turn the heat down to low. Today the portion of the soup that I'm making is for 4. And while the soup is simmering away, I'll be cooking rice for 4. Put the lid back on and we'll simmer this for 1 hour. I'll see you back in a while. Now we are going to cook our crispy rice. Heat up some oil over medium heat. I have with me over here half a bowl of cooked rice which I've cooled down about 2 hours or so. So how do you know whether the oil is hot enough? Just take 1 or 2 grains, just put it in. Right, we need it to sizzle like this. Okay, that means now this oil is hot enough. We'll just put them in, try to separate them out. You can use more or less rice according to your preference. Basically, the rice is to give a crispy texture to the dish. Do not worry about them clumping together because once they crisp up, it's easy to separate them. We are just going to fry this to a light golden brown, or when you don't see as much bubbles as there are now. This crispy rice is also what makes this dish very special. I love the different texture in this dish, and to me, this is a must-have. They might crackle and pop a little bit, so just be careful. Right, there's hardly any bubbles now, so we'll remove them from the hot oil. Don't turn off the heat yet, otherwise the oil will be lodged inside the rice. After this, I will show you how we fry some crispy eggs. Now we are going to deep fry our eggs. I have with me over here 2 eggs beaten using the same oil that I use to deep fry my rice. I'm using medium heat now. Use a strainer, strain the egg through the strainer. Make sure that oil is hot and just move them around. Tear the eggs apart. This crispy egg will add a very nice texture to the dish, so I really recommend you doing this. Once the egg has set, turn the heat up to medium high. We want to brown this and really puff this up. It's important not to use too low a heat, otherwise the egg will be soaking up a lot of oil. Brown this up really, really nicely. If you do not want the eggs in this dish, of course you can always skip this step. It will not affect the overall taste of the dish. Remember to move them around. We want to brown them, not burn them. When they are starting to brown like this, we'll remove them from heat because the residual heat will actually cook this further. So we'll remove this from oil and just set them aside. Using the same oil that we fried the egg with, we remove most of the oil, leaving just a little bit behind. Add in 20 grams of bait fish. I've washed and rinsed them. Just put them in. We need to fry this until they are crispy. Use medium-low heat to do this. So same thing, this is to add a very nice crispy texture to the dish. If you cannot get bait fish, you can always replace this with anchovies, no problem at all. We'll slowly brown them. Of course, a much faster way to do this is actually to deep fry them, but I don't want to deep fry way too much things. So I like this to be a little bit drier and crispy and not too oily. Once they are brown like this, turn off the heat and just set them aside. Now we are going to fry our garlic. Heat up a pan, add in a little bit more oil. I'm using medium heat over here. Do not turn the heat up way too high, otherwise you'll burn your garlic. Swirl the oil around. I'm using half a bulb of garlic, chopped up. Just put them in. I'm making garlic oil and crispy garlic so that I can drizzle some of this on the dish to give it an additional flavor. We'll fry this until they are slightly golden brown. Remember not to turn up the heat way too high because we don't want to burn this. Remember to move them around. Okay, as you can see, some of them has already started to brown. We will now remove them from the heat. I've been simmering the soup for 1 hour already. Let's have a look. Right. Smells very, very good. You know, just remove all this prawn heads, anchovies, as well as the chicken feet from the soup stock. Instead of throwing away the anchovies, you can actually remove the white peppercorn from it, salt it a little bit, and just roast it. It'll be a very nice snack to go with beer. So let me just remove all this and I'll show you the next step. Bring the soup back up to a boil and we'll add some seasoning. We'll start by adding just 1 teaspoon of salt first and we'll give it a taste. Give it a stir. Oh, look at how beautiful the color is. Wow. Felt like the ocean is swirling inside my mouth. Very, very good. So 1 teaspoon is good enough. We'll now add in our prawns. I have with me over here approximately 500 grams of prawns. When the soup is boiling, we'll add them in. Add in also Chinese cabbage, right? Sliced thinly like this. This is approximately 100 grams. Put it in. We'll wait for this to come to a boil before we add in our scallops. Once we start to see the soup boiling, we'll add in our scallops. I have with me over here approximately 150 grams of scallops. I'll just put them all in. Just cook them for about a minute or so. When we start to see the soup boiling, that means this is done. We'll assemble our dish now and have our lunch. So now I'll assemble the dish. I'll just add a piece of lettuce over here just to add color to this dish. Put your rice in a bowl like this. Scoop up the soup as well as the ingredients that you like. This is a serving for one. This is amazingly delicious. And now add in as much or as little of the prawns and scallops as you want. Yep. Now let's put the finishing touch before we dig in. The crispy egg. This is a must for me, a little bit more. Let it soak up the beautiful broth that we have prepared. The crispy rice. Add in a little bit of this. If you like more, put in more, no problem. The bait fish. I love this too. And of course, the garlic oil. Now if you like to have some peppery taste, by all means add a few dashes of pepper too. So let's dig in. And now the dish is done. Let's have a taste. Wow, really, really very fragrant. Mm. One mouthful and it's like the whole ocean is swirling in your mouth. It's really, 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 really good. Mm. So ladies and gentlemen, I hope you like our video. Do click like on our video and do subscribe to our channel. Thank you for watching. Yes?